Are you coexisting or are you being pushed into obsolescence by the digital revolution? Visual arts and the digital.
Sa visual art, marami na kasing mga interpretation ng mga images through digital means. But at the same time, I think what SSCA now is doing is basically going back to the basic of creation. I mean, looking back to the materiality of around you, no, na pwede mong gamitin for your art pieces. So hindi lang technology yung pinagbabatayan ng creativity, but also the materials that's available, materials. The stones, the leaves that's available, the weaving in your area. Huwag nating tingnan na laging nasa West yung concept ng development ng art, but rather looking to the materials that we have available in our place. Magkaroon tayo ng pride na yun yung gamitin natin sa ating expression sa sining.
Lalo na sa visual at saka sa architecture. Nakakarinig ako ng mga comments na di ka naman kinakailangan mahusay. Everything is in the internet.
No. During our time, we do drafting manually.
Ngayon?
Computer-aided draft, SCAD. It would be easier for students to develop plans, but seemingly, we always adapt. You have to have a concept and the philosophy.
So is digital good or bad to architecture?
We allow thesis to be done in digital, but sa lower years, we require them to do hand drafting.
Sa artists?
Well, we still prepare.
Naririnig mo yun?
Naririnig namin yan. It's a debate, actually. But among the artists, I think we still prefer, kasi digital is a soft, diba? Software. But I think most of the artists here, at least, no, from the region I've been to, and even in Metro Manila, we would prefer the hardware.
Sa musika, sa teatro, kumusta? I mean, what is the role of the internet, the digital revolution?
For music, it helps music a lot.
It does.
Because, number one, it records everything, and it preserves the music. Number two, it has a far reach, not only for our country, but the whole world.
That's true. Mm. Literary arts.
For instance, I will pick up on that reach. We have a poet in Cebu who is based already in Kansas, but he built this Kabisdak, Balay Balak Asoy. And it's a hub for all the Cebuano writers outside of Cebu, those who are based abroad, those who are based in Mindanao, all over they contribute. And so what he does is to publish a poem every day. And sometimes the students use that archive for their, you know, like assignments, for their thesis.
Mr. Blanco.
For theater, we use technology to our advantage. There are a lot of productions now that uses really digital, interplay with the digital, like use of images, visual yes. images. Na, for example, the IPAG of the Mindanao of MSU IIT, they use a lot of the visual display with text, dance, poetry, and the visual images. So para sa teatro, mas ano siya, mas advantageous sa amin kasi. I mean, we always claim that theater is a collaborative form of art. Ginagamit namin yung mga other disciplines para maging isa siya. So mas ano siya, mas happy kami kasi mas marami kaming mga possible sources na magagamit in our work.
Sa cinema, Teddy?
Oh, sa cinema, of course, it's gone completely digital, no? I mean, especially in the last 10 years, no? So ever since digital filmmaking was introduced 20 years ago, no? And digital cinema has just democratized filmmaking. It has created so many platforms, no? And because cinema was so technological, it was so equipment heavy, so expensive to make, I think it has now is now in sync with all the other art forms, no? That almost anybody now can make a film, no? Because you can use your smartphone, you can edit on your computer. And then, if you just want to send it out, you don't even have to. Before, you had to send out all those heavy reels, no? And then send them by freight. Now, you can just upload them on a computer and then send the link to some people in another country, and then they can watch your film, no? The important thing now is how to curate all of this stuff and create meaning out of it and package these works into a form for the. You know, for the public to watch and appreciate.
Magandang gabi, Pilipinas. Welcome to The Bottom Line.